My name's Felix Thompson, and I'm the writer-director of the film King Jack. King Jack is a film, it's a story about a 15-year-old kid, this kind of delinquent kid who's essentially the last person you'd give any responsibility to, like, ever. And it's about this one weekend where he has to look after his little cousin for 2 days, which turns into the kind of best and worst weekend of his life. It's this sort of ode to I think, a childhood that a lot of us had. I mean, you've got the kind of girl who you're always chasing but is so out of reach and, like, not the person you should be going for. You have the kind of, you have this very sinister bully character named Shane. You have this kind of younger cousin, Ben, who's essentially, like, he's just the last kid you'd want to have following you around all day. He's the kid that you're just like, this kid's going to ruin whatever tiny bit of reputation I have. It's a film. I mean, in some ways, it's very much a film about how to be a man. And I think what I really enjoyed about it is that all of the male characters are so flawed, with the exception of Ben, who's the youngest. He's kind of like he's the kind of wisest character in it, even though he's, you know, 12. I mean, the casting process was we knew it was going to be tough because we had such a young kind of cast and such a big young cast. We had an amazing casting director, though, A.B. Kaufman, who came on board and was just absolutely incredible. She helped us find Charlie Plummer, who plays Jack, who I have to say is just one of the most talented actors I've ever gotten to work with. And he was 14 when he came to that audition room. I mean, we were really blown away when he came in. And the rest of the cast kind of followed suit around that. We wanted to find him first. So then we found Danny Flaherty, who plays Shane, who's incredible. Christian Madsen, who plays Tom, who's just has this kind of, like, power, like, physical presence on the screen that I thought was really important. And then Ben, all the characters were really, it was funny. There was no backup for any of them. For the kid who played Ben, Corey, for the girls, for Harriet, who was played by Yanise. None of those characters was I like, oh, if this person can't do it, maybe we can use this person. It was just them or nothing. With this film, we really wanted it to feel like this was the kind of weekend that Jack would look back on 10 years later with a fondness, right? So there was this sense that we wanted it to feel a bit like a faded photograph or a faded memory. And so it was really important to us that it have this sense of kind of romanticism and nostalgia to it. So as a result, I mean, if you see the film, I think the kind of the color of it, the way in which we shot it, feels very authentic and grounded, but also has this slight edge of romanticism to it. It's fantastic to be here for the festival. It is just so cool. We were here with our first short a few years ago. And to be back with a feature just is an incredible, incredible experience. I hope that people come away with it with a bit of a smile and feel uplifted. And I also think, you know, for me, this is a film about what I think growing up is, which I think growing up is learning to care about other people more than you care about yourself. So I hope that people kind of come away with that message as well.